Google has been releasing a lot of interesting AI models recently, such as PaLM 2, and it's possible to use these large language models in your own software services and applications. This is going to be easiest if your software systems are on Google Cloud Platform, as there's a tight integration between these large language models and GCP's AI services. However, it is possible to use these models in other cloud and non-cloud environments. Today, we'll walk you through a number of different approaches for that. We do want to be clear, though, that we're talking about using the PaLM 2 language models from outside of Google Cloud. We're not talking about running or porting those models to non-Google environments. That's not currently possible. For environments outside of Google Cloud, where we want to use these models for AI-powered experiences, we'll typically want to consider shell-based approaches, programming language SDKs, or frameworks like Langchain. Our one and only constraint here is that we're going to need this environment to have internet access so that it can reach out to Google and use the PaLM APIs. Let's get started in the Google Cloud Console, where we'll need to enable the Vertex AI APIs. Next, we'll set up a service account, which we can use to authenticate with Google Cloud in our various environments and applications. When you create that service account, be sure to include Vertex AI user permissions. This is going to give your applications, services, or automation tooling enough permissions to use the PaLM Large Language Model APIs, but does not include excessive admin-like permissions. Once you've created that service account, be sure to export a JSON service account key. This file will be used for our client configurations. I'm starting a GitHub repository, which we'll share in the description of this video for you to be able to follow along. We'll start with the Python and Langchain-based approaches for calling the PaLM 2 language model. While we're going to use an IDE, keep in mind that you could use these exact same approaches and code snippets in your application source code, whether that's on or off Google Cloud. For the Python-based approach, we can jumpstart things by getting code directly from the Generative AI Studio. Now, in the question that we'd like to ask, we can type in any text and then click on View Code. We've got some Python code here. Specifically, it's going to use the prompt that we've typed into the text area. There's only two important steps that we need to keep in mind before we can use the code here. First, let's export as an environment variable our JSON key file for the service account. This is going to be used by the Python code to infer what credentials we want to use. And again, we'll just be using that service account that we created. The other piece is, if we don't already have it, we do need to install this client library that we're importing here, and that's going to be from PyPy under the name Google Cloud AI Platform. The straight Python approach is particularly nice for your applications, services, or other software written in Python, but there are SDKs available in other languages as well. Next up, let's use a somewhat similar approach, but at a different level of abstraction by using the Langchain project. If you haven't installed the Langchain library, be sure to do so with pip. Within the last week or two, the latest Langchain release does have support for the PaLM models on Vertex AI. So we're going to import the Vertex AI endpoint here. And if we've done that export for our JSON key file, we can just use that directly with a command like this. Let's create the same prompt, and then we'll run that prompt through the PaLM model. We're getting an error because of a naming collision since our Python file is named Langchain, so we'll revise that a little bit and call this our library-based approach. So as opposed to the pure Python approach, this can be nice if we have data or AI pipelines. Overall, our code will tend to be cleaner and leaner if we use these frameworks instead of pure Python. Finally, let's use a CLI API-based approach. It will be another case of reusing code that we get in the terminal. I'll copy that code and bring it into our bash script. Now, note that this approach is slightly different in that we're using the gcloud command to be able to get an access token. So we need to install that CLI and use the gcloud auth activate service account and specify the key file like we did in the environment variable based approach. This API-based approach is most useful if we have application code that doesn't have an existing client SDK. We could use any language to make this sort of API call, and this is also sometimes useful for automation tooling, such as something like GitHub Actions, where we have a more command line interface and shell scripting approach rather than using programming languages. These are just a few of the ways that we can use the PaLM large language model outside of Google Cloud. We can keep our PaLM security configuration pretty lean inside Google Cloud to support that, with these integrations then just being a matter of ensuring internet access and using a service account with the standard service account key-based client authentication mechanisms. We hope this video was helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions that you have. Thank you for watching.